Amen. Oh, give it to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. Unto you and me, I was glad. When they said, unto you and unto me, let us come into the house of God. Oh, shout to the Lord of the Lord. Hallelujah! I wanted to move from where you are. Go and give somebody a powerful fight. Give that person fire. Give that person fire. Jesus! Celebrate Jesus! Father, we thank you, Father, we bless your holy name. Today is also another day. Father, without you, we can do nothing. Father, we are in your presence. Spirit of God, speak through us, O God. Father, bless us with your word. Father, open our heart, O God. Let us receive your word. Father, change us, O God. Renew our spirit. Renew our heart, O God. Father, let us be a blessing. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let the saints say amen. Give a powerful clap offering unto the Elion God, unto the Nisi God, that I am God. Hallelujah. Amen. God, my man, tell me I can see what me do. Abrabos. Amen. We are teaching on a subject, the armor of God. Last Friday I was here. We studied the armor of God. This Friday also I was here. We are all studying the armor of God. So I am preaching a subject, the same similar to that, so that we know how we will stand. And we know how we will battle with the spirit. Because Ephesians 6 makes us know that we are not raised against. We are not raised against flesh and the blood. It's not ordinary flesh that we are fighting against. And we are not fighting against ordinary blood. But we are fighting against principalities. Powers, the spiritual battles. I call them the white powers and the black ones. We are the Kakafifi and the Katabilis. The Kakafifi are the witches, the small witches. And the Kakaopa are the big witches. We are fighting against them. Not in the physical battle, but in the spiritual battle. So we know. And we have to stand firmly so that we wear all the armor of God in order to fight against him. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I said on Friday that the Bible says we should receive the devil. We should receive them. But there are some believers, if they don't take care, the devil will rather resist with the believers. There are some believers. If we don't take care, they will rather resist us. But God has given you power. Amen. I didn't hear. God has given you power. Amen. God has given you power. Amen. To overcome them. Say amen. So I am preaching on the subject. Success destroyer. Amen. Or success killer. Amen. Say to someone, dealing with success killer. Success killer. And ask your neighbor, who is success killer? Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Yeah. I want to explain the sources. In Oxford's advanced dictionary defines sources are the accomplishment of an aim or a purpose. So in simple terms, is to achieve something that we have been trying to do or get. That causes us. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. So ask someone beside you, who is your success killer? Who is your success destroyer? This morning, God will give you power to overcome them. Send me to that. Hallelujah. Amen. The agent of devil to set themselves against you or against your success in progress in life. There are some entities, there are some spirits. There are some people that the enemies or the devil use them. They work through them to fight against your success. What you have tried to achieve, what God has blessed you with, Jesus is still working for you. Say amen. They do everything in their powers. These successes on this way, they do everything in their powers, in their authority. And they work always 24 hours to free someone. Either they want you to fail in life, or either they want what you have achieved to destroy. These are called success killers. But listen, in the book of Genesis chapter 3, in the Garden of Eden, when you read verse 2, you turn to verse 6, 9 to 11. Do you know that Adam was created to have all dominion, everything in the garden, except the tree of life and death? And do you know when the serpent, the evil spirit, want to attack Adam, he went through Eve. The serpent told Eve, what did God told you? And so, oh, God has given all these things into my hand, except these three. The serpent said, oh, why? Why can't you touch this tree? It will not do you anything, just touch it. The Bible said, he stretched up his hands and touched Jesus. See? Where was the hand of him? Why can't you say, who meant to be a teen? See anything? They will see. That was the second test. Or touching the sea. Bible say, see, it didn't do him anything. Say, yes. God is deceiving you. God is telling you all lies. You see that? You are not dying. Go and give some to your husband. Beloved in Christ, the target was not the woman. The target was the man. Because Bible said, the woman is out of a womb that bring a man. Out of a womb that bring man. So God created man and the family. But the serpent want to destroy the family. Want to destroy anything that the man will achieve on this earth. Because it's the man who produce. This money has been to someone's life. Anything you are trying to achieve, and the serpent is working in all corner to destroy. May God give you power to overcome them. May God give you power to overcome them. Praise God. So in Genesis chapter 3, verse number 2, and the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the tree of the garden. But on the fruit of the tree, which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall ye touch it, lest it die. Verse 6. So the Bible said, he picked some of the tree or the seed and gave unto the man. After the man ate it, they saw that they are in nakedness. And the Bible says, verse 9 to 11, when God was coming into the garden, Adam and Eve were nowhere to be found. The prayer that God put them, they have changed their location. They have changed their location. Beloved in Christ, now may I place you in the right position. God has given you something into your hand, but devil is trying to fight against you. So now, he has made your mind to go all round. But yes, sir, and you're meant to be going. I'll pray, when the member of power will make this finish as a prayer. Yeah. The Bible said, Adam, where are you? Where are you? I praise you here. Here is your sitting place. Where are you? This is your place. Why is it that you are going to sit at the back? Where are you? To God, when I get you, you don't need it. Because it's a danger. Who told you why nakedness? Also, Obama, what did he man? Obama said, I am a servant. That how serpent wanted her to destroy the goodness of Adam. This morning I'm praying. Any power that tried to destroy your goodness, that tried to destroy the good thing that you do, may God fight against them. May God fight against them. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Beloved, write this down. Success speak louder than words. Success speak louder than words. Yes, if someone got pressed somewhere, and you see the appearance, you see where the person is coming. Nobody will tell you that. From the head to the toe, you can calculate it. Let's put that one aside. If you see someone that God has blessed you, changing your life, changing your family, somebody who knows you formally, when the person sees you today, he said that you are really blessed. Because at first, and yes, sign and now what here? What does now but we see we talk. But this time, when you are coming, it seems there is a star that you put yourself. Even in the way I will put yourself. What kind of now who are you? Here alone. What to do we say? Tell you what, making that step. Now Obia will say, no so.
David was put in charge. All the Israel came to David
said, David, you are the Jewish man. Come and be our king. David was once a shepherd, far away in the wilderness. But when God anointed came upon David, he was called to be the king. So all the house of Israel came to say, David, we want you to be our king. May this anointing come upon you. May this fire fall in your life. In the name of Jesus, any success killer who try to fight against what you have achieved, may God scatter them in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Who are the success killers? I've explained the success. Who are the success killers? In Exodus chapter 22, verse number 18, God gave a commandment to Moses. God gave a commandment to Moses. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live. So one of the sources killers are witches. The killers, okay, was a woman and get to work. But woman almost said that they more. Witches always destroy them. They can walk through any tunnel. They can walk through any place to destroy what you have achieved. May God give you power. May God give you anointing. So as we are talking about the armor of God, we need to wear all that armor so that we can fight against them. Praise God. Now, number two, we have agent of familiar spirits. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 31. Leviticus chapter 19, verse 31. The agents of familiar spirits. They give no regard to menial and familiar spirits. Do not seek after them to be defiled by them. But I will say, I am the Lord of God. Do you know how devil went through the familiar spirit? They are people so close to you. There are some people who always know where you are. They know what you have achieved. They know your plan. So the devil went to them. That is why you may dream and in your vision, you may see someone that you love. Someone that is close to you, holding a catwalk to bite you and kill you. And you said, this is a, hey, this is a witch. This is a, want to destroy me. From today, may they not earn 90 people. It's not true. And then it's not a yampa. Catch on, there's nothing in a yampa. Because the serpent used your girlfriend. What person was scattered is your name in the morning. Because it is through this leader that God wants to bless you. He wants to bring that to you. Oh, you need to go to the there are so many people. By being a media chevy, anyway, in Ayaka. There are so many people. Opportunities in Ayaka. Your break is our opportunity. May God help you this morning. May God open another door for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Give me a believing amen. Amen. Number three, I said it last week. These are the wolves in sheep clothing. These are people who have charisma, but not of a good character of a Christ. Be full in them. Let's read Acts chapter 20, verse 29. To gentlemen. They have charisma, but these people don't have good character in them. You call them wolves. Naya, what kind of thing? You will be over. You will be a sheep, now some of your sheep. Are you there? For I know this, that after my departure, shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flocks. Also of your own self shall men arise. Your own self shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. This is a word from Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ knows that there are people that he has blessed, but there are some spirits called destiny destroyers, success killers, destiny hijackers. One time, my baby to church. Destiny hijackers. What was I want to fight you? You might be afraid to introduce. You have hijacked your blessing. We have all those spirits. But this morning, I'm giving you the guidelines so that you know how to battle with them. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, praise God.
Hallelujah.
So Jesus knows that there are some people are sheep, but they are called themselves as a wolf. It was me quieting and crowfobi baba mu. What are you almost doing? Take it. That is your last Friday question. There are some people that will pretend as if they know all the Bible. They know everything in the Bible. And what they are saying is the right way. But they don't have Spirit of God to interpret the writing to you. They will deceive you with enticing words. Paul said, I'm not here to speak enticing words to you, but I'm here to speak the powerful word of God to you. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So you need to be alert with those people. Can't you only ask them when you know what? Can't you go for us when you know? They are agents. They have charisma. Do you know the charisma? They have all the good things to deceive people. One another thing. They can even gather some people. Nobody is some people. No one can say. Don't listen to them. They are deceiving you. They are telling you lies. That is what the serpent did to Adam and Eve. With the angel, give it. This is how the devil went through our wives and our husbands. This is why the devil went through our children. They tell them, this cannot do anything. Wait, enter in your tree. We are the tree. Now, no one's obeying and we're married here. But because of the wedding thing, I'm going to remember when you have to share the problem of cancer. The devil wants to attack you. So, behold, woman will say, and then your girlfriend, and she and I have another girlfriend, the third time, and your girlfriend, you will be aware of when it is here. Because what are they thinking about you? After woman will say, well, destroy everything that you have achieved. The devil used some people that even we receive them into our house. Our friend that they come to our house, when they come to your house, they see all the things that is in your room and say, hey, they say, yeah, how about this? Yeah, God has blessed me. How about this? Yes, I have this. I have this. From that going, you see all eyes on you. Bible said, God spoke to a prophet to go and tell Ezekiel, you will die. Why? Because you have revealed everything in your columns. Everything in your room. You have revealed it. We are coming to possess it. Father, I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Go be the our target. I ready to see it come through our lives. Go be the our target to bless him. I ready to make the big colors. I'm in the air. I'm in the air. Hallelujah. Listen, the Bible said, Matthew chapter 7, verse 15 to 16. He said, a good tree cannot bear a bad fruit. And a bad tree cannot bear a good fruit. So there are some people among us. They are destroyers. You see their nature. You see their lives. You see how they speak. You see how they are doing their things. Be careful of them. Be careful of them. Be aware of them. May God speak to you this morning.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Matthew chapter 15, verse 7, the Bible says, this hypocrite, what did Isaiah, prophet of Isaiah, the prophet say, verse 18, these people draw near unto me with their lips, with their mouth, but honor me with their lips, but their heart is far away from me. Praise God, hallelujah, praise God, hallelujah. Sons of God, my father, the God of Zion.
Because you don't pay your tithe. God, you're going to your tithe, man. Catcher, yeah, be a title. Oh, my two, Catcher. God is a piano on your feet. Hallelujah. Amen.
So we need to draw a blood line between those spirits and us. And how to draw the line?
Number two is your prayer line.
You need to increase your prayer line. Amen.
Tell someone beside you, increase your prayer line.
Number three, stop sharing your success with some friends. Stop sharing your success with some friends. I know you know how to drive a car. I know it. You have to drive a car. I know God has blessed you. I know even your dress speaks for you. Your dress speaks for you. But there are some people, they can dress nicely. But if you go into their wallet and their pocket, you will see paper. They make paper kufu. Nothing to be. They don't have anything, but they prove themselves. They get at their place. Stop sharing your ideas with those people. They are stopped. They will destroy your blessings. They are destroyers. Can't you always say, yes, you can't say that. What can't say that? You can't say that. 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 We need my dear ABC. Can't you always say that? What's the music? Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, I say. Now one day said, when this guy got killed, you didn't go and I'm saying, and I'm here saying, I'm here saying. I feel your son and when you have it. What I know was a son I have a son, I said, no, who's you? Boots I know who can kill or not one guy. But I said, I'm a wolf. I don't pay rent only about what I told you that's when I'm going to go only. Your good news is a bad news now. Your celebration, how you want to celebrate? They are envy about your celebration. So stop sharing your ideas with them. Your family member or your household can stand against your blessings. They can, the devil can want you to pollute some people's mind. Yes. But who's I never waiting on? I have overcome all those things. I know. I've experienced it. She said, one more when you have
but I was on the first one saying, I don't pay for the own mobile. I don't pay for the own mobile.
There is a member of my church, This lady, God used to me to pray this lady. He had two houses now. Cars and other things we don't mention. He was a member of a Methodist church. She gave a birth. And then baby died. She was also in that church. When she entered the church, you see the mothers, hey, the man of Shambo, and the man of AC. There were some people on the catch and say, hey, oh, nobody will move by AC. All sorts of things. So she came to our prayer meeting Wednesday morning. We pray, God revealed, we prophesied. Behold, the lady became a member of our church. One of our culture is all who be wondering. And then, Nami Abelasim will pray in case. He's a manager in a car park in Ghana. Let me tell you, sister. If you know how to keep your secret, God will bless you.
Amen.
Know how to keep your secret.
Amen.
And serve your God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is other way. kyerɛ na akɔfa ɛnneɛma nyame de ahyɛ ne nyina wane consulted some of them, my girlfriend pastors, my so-called prophets, they gave her something. Now, what they are ato the bottom, no one to and they are missing them. Not knowing, say, I know any grown up church in the mission. That they are the national bottom. Missy, no, she'll be good. No, she'll be good. Levitan is not our people are rare, are good. Be alert with yourself. Hallelujah. So when somebody in Amini is a shower, that will be my working. What do you do? But on some working at Jesus and before, and then will be a stores, our condition, everywhere in Amisha. But then our back squares some. Baba squares some. My Bible said, I did be a media man, mommy. Don't listen to the absolute gospel. The Bible said in 1 Samuel chapter 15, Absalom prayed to kill his father. They take possession of him. The keys. Amen. When the moment comes, there are some people when their pastor is not there. You see, underground work. No more working. How can somebody tell you? You are fighting on the child. One more man, you are not fighting here. Sister, no one ever was so. Can't you answer my wedding? I'm not so. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Bible said in the first Kings, if you read first Kings chapter 1, verse number 11. Through 1 Kings chapter 1, verse number 11 to 14. A man was a man, 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 a who is a sausage destroyer? He's one of the sons of David. Adonijah recognized that his father is a big king. And there are some, what do you call, Solomon is there. Solomon is also there. But there was a prophecy that Solomon will inherit the keys. And this destroyer went to Adonijah. And Adonijah was looking for his father concubine, the beautiful one. He was looking for. A man of penalty. What boy ever got our people? Mommy, you come here, Papa. Tell me, no fight in the end. So he gathered all people with him and started pronouncing, I am the king. I am the king. I am the king. I am the king. Beloved in Christ, I'm a brother, make a tell myself, what your bad boy, you're not swamp, because I didn't be a young bad yellow, and that's what we did to him. What your bad boy, you're not swamp, I didn't be a young bad yellow, and that's what we did to him. Don't they hear it? I am teaching some people Bible. Hallelujah. Where the Bible said, then people brought a plan to take the kingship. But the kingship was false. Solomon. So there was a prophet called Nathan. God revealed to Nathan, go and tell Bathsheba. Bathsheba, one thing, the woman, a tapadena, who could not pay a be the influencer. And then I did get my brother. No, we are planning so many of you. I will cast out. I will not cast out. Anything that belongs to you, and the devil wants to snatch it out of your hand, may God speak for you. May God intercede for you. May God fight against them. Those who are fighting against you, may God fight against them. Those who have rights against you, may God have rights against them. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every word that they are planning, may God reveal it to you. May God reveal it to you. May God reveal it to you. In the mighty name of Jesus, give me a clap of hands. Prophet Margaret said, a good funny catch them. What they are told? Verse 11. I said, and the Lord stand up. Now, verse 11, 11, 12, the entry can't help. Your mom running by. Back to verse 11. As I said, wherefore the Lord said unto Solomon, for as much as this is done of thee, and thou hast not kept my covenant and my statutes, whether I have commanded thee, I will surely reign the kingdom from thee, and I will give it to thyself. Notwithstanding, in the days I will not wait for David, thy father's sake, but I will render it out of the hand of thy son. Hallelujah. Anything that belongs to you, and some people are working for that corner to get it. May God destroy their plans. May God break their spirit. May you receive the good thing of that. May you receive the blessings of it. In the name of Jesus. Why are you being now? Why are you confused in life? Who would you ever say that way? Who plans in our hearts? Attempt the word to your heart. Who are more commanded than the enemy? You did the other kind of the world. One thing I'm here to say. Because all your mind and your plans, your power, who are part of your work, pass it. And who see a solid amount? Why are you now? And when he received the direction from God, he went straight to David and told David, don't you know that your son Absalom, Adonijah, is taking my son King's seat? And David said, over my dead body, as far as I live, Solomon will take my King's seat. I prophesy over your life. May you receive good things that belongs to you. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I can be that me a plenty of whoop. Let me be there. And I prophesy. And I'm my name. May you give back to it. May you give back to that. May you give back to that. Hallelujah. And then we are in this way. Financial destroyers be able to abandon us. See, can't talk. Sometimes we will do this kind of thing. It's financial destroyers. But I remember when they now what?
Amen.
Okay, Isaiah chapter 32, Isaiah 22, 23, verse 22. What say? God will be an enemy against your enemies.
Amen.
I prophesy over your life. May God be an enemy against your enemies.
Amen.
May God be an enemy against your enemies.
Amen.
Your army is too weak.
Amen.
I'm going to send you a resolution. May God be an enemy against your enemy.
Amen.
May God be an enemy. Your enemies, may God fight for you.
Amen.
Any spirit that is fighting against your prospect, that is fighting against your position, may God fight against it. 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 Isaiah said, no weapons, no weapons. If you know that you have the armor of God, you said to yourself, no weapons. Oh. Say, no weapons. Prophesy, prophesy. No weapons. No weapons. No weapons. Form against me. Oh, no weapons. Form against my family. No weapons. Form against my blessing. No weapons. Form against my blessing. No weapons. Form against my household. No weapons. Form against my position. No weapons. Form against me. Will prosper. They will be strong. By the power of God. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. In Isaiah chapter 10, he said, let them gather together. Don't care about them. If they are sending your picture into idols, that way that they spoke, we are speaking another way. We are speaking another way. One way can change your life. One way can change your life. One way can change your life. Hey, let them speak the word. It shall come to nothing. It shall come to nothing. It shall come to nothing. Because the Lord is with us. Because the Lord is with us. Ah, there are children of God here. The Lord is with you. This week the Lord is with you. Oh, this one the Lord will be with you. The Lord will go before you. The Lord will go before you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. In Psalm 23, Kadima Handaya. In Psalm 23. The Bible said, unlike verse 4 and verse 5 and verse 6, was ye do, ye do, ye do, ye do. I walk through, I walk through the fury of death. There are children of God over here. What's it about? I walk through the fury. I'm in a motion, so I'm on the to trample Don't go and get so long, baby. I said, I'm running away from you.